He was one of the shortest people I have ever known. He was also one of the most despicable people I ever knew. And his name was Bob. And he was my boss. Of course, his stature and his despicableness have nothing to do with one another, right? But when you already don't like somebody, it's easy to make judgments about how they look. Perhaps that was the case with Zacchaeus. In the words of the children's song I grew up with, Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. This wee little man was a tax collector, a chief tax collector, meaning that other people worked for him, collecting taxes, and he got a cut of all of those taxes. It was a lucrative business, and Zacchaeus was very rich, Luke implies. Tax collectors in the ancient Roman world actually purchased the right to collect taxes, sort of like people in New York purchase taxi medallions. But unlike the taxi business in New York, the tax business in ancient Rome was unregulated. They were free agents, and as Pastor Emily told us last week, they were allowed to collect as much money as they could browbeat out of people. They paid Rome what was due Rome, and then they kept the rest for themselves. And the people hated them. One day Jesus was passing through Jericho, and Zacchaeus, whose name, by the way, means righteous, was determined to get a good look at this miracle worker, and so he ran ahead of all the other people and he climbed a tree. Both running and climbing trees were not something a man in his social position would have done, but he really wanted to see Jesus. Up in the branches of that sycamore tree, Zacchaeus had a bird's eye view of the young rabbi surrounded by an excited and growing crowd of people. The rabbi just kept coming closer and closer, and then in a moment worthy of an old Hollywood film, Jesus stopped directly under the tree, paused, gazed up in the branches, and saw Zacchaeus, the wee little man dressed in his fine linen. Jesus seemed to already know who he was and called him by name. Zacchaeus, hurry up and come down out of that tree because I'm going to your house for dinner today. And Zacchaeus was delighted at the prospect of entertaining a celebrity, but the crowd was not delighted at all. Why would Jesus choose to dine with a bum like him, a man who had robbed them time and again? And so they began to rumble and grumble and said what people were always saying about Jesus. He hangs out with all the wrong kind of people. Jesus didn't tell Zacchaeus that he needed to repent, but Zacchaeus did anyway. I suppose if any of us were suddenly in the presence of Jesus, we might repent too. And having repented, he declared, "Look, half of my possessions, Lord, I will give to the poor, and if I have defrauded anybody of anything, I will pay them back four times what I took to them." It's quite a promise. Could have bankrupted him, really. I imagine that Jesus smiled from ear to ear, and turning to that grumbling crowd, he said, "Today, salvation has come to this house because this wee little man right here is a son of Abraham." The Gospel of Luke places a great deal of emphasis on Jesus finding lost things, lost sheep, lost coins, and in this case, a lost son of Abraham. That is the standard interpretation of this story, that Zacchaeus was lost in his sin and found by a Savior. But Gospel of Luke is also known for its surprising role reversals. Luke likes to turn our expectations upside down on their heads, thus exposing us in our own duplicity and complicity. Luke loves to surprise those of us who think we know how a story ought to end. And there are some scholars who think that that is exactly what Luke is doing here, that this is a classic tale of role reversal. Why do they think that? Well, it's an argument based on grammar and also how translation is really interpretation. In most English translations of the Bible, when Zacchaeus speaks to Jesus, it is translated in the future tense. I will give the poor half of my possessions. I will pay back fourfold anyone I have defrauded. But these scholars point out that this is a classic case of the translators making an interpretive decision. Because the Greek verbs here are actually in the present tense, not the future tense. And read as written, literally, Zacchaeus actually said, I give half of my possessions to the poor. I pay back fourfold anyone I have defrauded. And if that is what he really said, then that would make this story more like this. There was a man named Zacchaeus who was a chief tax collector. And because he was, everyone thought they knew who he was. And they hated him because of a label, even though they had never spoken to him, even though they didn't know him. And besides all that, he was short. He had heard of a man named Jesus, and he was excited by his message. When Jesus came to his town, Zacchaeus ran ahead of the crowd and climbed a tree to get a better view. After a few minutes, Jesus stood under the tree, looked up, smiled broadly at a kindred spirit, and said, Zacchaeus, come on down. We're eating at your house today. This delighted the little man, but infuriated the crowd. They were sure that Jesus was a poor judge of character, and so they grumbled about Shorty and Jesus. But Zacchaeus, finally having the chance to tell the story for himself, finally having the ear of his accusers, finally in the presence of his neighbors who had never spoken to him because they were sure they knew exactly who he was, he said, but Lord, I give half of my possessions to the poor, and if I have defrauded anybody, I always pay them back four times what I took. Present tense. In this telling, Zacchaeus, the little, wee little man, was actually a stand-up guy. Huh? His mother got it right when she named him righteous. He didn't become a son of Abraham that day. He already was a son of Abraham. And the people in the crowd, well, they were the lost ones that Jesus came to seek and save. And that makes us lost when we sit in rooms like this one and are sure that we know the motivations of other people whose labels we think we know. So which of these interpretations is correct, James? They both are. Both. Zacchaeus was a sinner saved by grace, and Zacchaeus was a righteous man who tried to do the right thing. Even if the second interpretation is correct, and Zacchaeus was a righteous man, do you honestly think that old Zac never had a bad day again? Do you not imagine that he was never tempted to take more than what was his when those bills were due and the car broke down and the kids needed braces? And that crowd, even if they were the righteous ones, do you think they were never tempted again to judge a book by its cover? And you and me, while we might feel close to Jesus now, sitting in this room with one another, perhaps we ought to check in with each other on Wednesday afternoon sometime. Jesus stood under a tree and said, "Zacchaeus, come on down, because I'm going to your house to eat." Maybe Jesus was going to eat with a sinner that day, or maybe he was going to eat with a saint, or maybe he was going to eat with someone who was, like us, a perplexing mixture of the two on any given day. But Jesus was going to eat with him just the same. And Jesus will eat with us just the same. Thanks be to God.